There is always the little voice in my head telling me a bit more again. But it's missing 30 seconds. Just one more.
That's so why we were late here today. Because you went, just one more run. Just one more.
Ciao, I'm Grat.
Hi, I'm Zara, and these are our 10 hot questions. How strict is Graziano when training? What do we call you? Sweet and?
Sour.
Sweet and sour. He's very, very, very sweet. And then sometimes when he, to be fair on you, when you've told me something 52,000 times.
52,001.
And one times. And then I still get it wrong. You look at me like.
Really? I'm just patient.
Who's most likely to have a meltdown during rehearsal? I volunteer as tribute.
You know what it is, obviously through the week, Monday is the worst day. Monday is the day where she's telling me, what is wrong with me?
Yeah, but then Tuesday, you feel, I think inside you feel like you should be more ahead than you actually are. Like you kind of know the steps, but I sometimes at this point don't feel like I'm confident enough to put the energy into it.
Okay.
And then true. I get frustrated.
That way is true.
And then I get annoyed at myself. And then I have a meltdown. But then very quickly, sometimes he gives me a snack or chocolate or something like that. And we recover very quickly and we're back to work.
She said it all.
Which judge do you most want to impress?
I think all of them. The thing is, we are trying every week and she's very, very good in that. She remember every judgment that we receive every weekend.
I do.
She remember, and every time we are rehearsing, she's like, yeah, but Anton said no more like that, but more like that. Sometimes I'm like, ooh. Why when I give you the step, sometimes you're like, which step it is? And but you remember every comments from the judges, which is good. But like we want to impress all of them. And at that moment, you just want to enjoy their performance. And then when you're in front of them, you just hope that they're going to say nice stuff.
What are your pre-performance rituals ahead of the Saturday show?
I think I've got yours. It's a weird one, but it's fine.
Go on.
You keep drinking water like... She got an obsession with water.
And
lip balm. Oh, but like, look at her lipstick. If you ask me 10 seconds ago before we sit here, she didn't have it, I swear, magic. Every time she's stressed, and then she put the water, and she keeps drinking, and then I need to go to the loo. We need to dance in 3 seconds. So
now everyone's gonna know.
What's really going through your head when you perform? What do you think? I think the performance is so quick. You don't realise it.
For me, I don't even realise there's an audience there. Do you feel the same?
I was waiting for that time for so much.
Really? Why?
So you can focus about your performance and then in the end...
Yeah, that was the right answer then. No, actually, I'll tell you what's going on in my head. Calm down, relax. It's fine. No one's watching you. This is just a dress run. This isn't live. That's what's going on in my head. But honestly, I say that to myself before every single.
Perfect.
This isn't live. No one's watching you.
This week the same. This week the same.
Of course.
Can we have the clip back?
So. Which contestant enjoys the spray tan booth the most? Vito likes the spray tan, doesn't he?
More than Vito. She's the host, Claudia.
Yeah, but she's not a contestant.
I know, but she's the one who makes me understand, like, it's time for spray tan.
Ellie has them a lot, but then I share a dressing room with Ellie, so I know that Ellie has a spray tan. I actually didn't have a spray tan this week. Fun fact. How did you cope with being in the dance-off?
In the worst case, I knew that in some way, in some week during our journey, that moment would come. And the fact that happened a bit early, I would say, but the fact that you handled it so well, I think it was a moment where I realized, okay, it's time to face the biggest fear of the competition.
Mm-hmm.
And if you remember, we were in that room because we warm up before to the dance-off. We got 10 minutes to warm up. And I look at her, the first moment I arrived in the room, she was like...
I was about to go.
She was all like close like this. And usually I'm like very strict. I went there and said, listen, you are strong. You got the steps. I want that you do exactly the same what you did, and the judges told you the same, and then you were like in the opposite direction. You were so ready. Did you realize we were dancing the Paso Doble? She was like, ah!
No, I, apparently I was screaming through the dance. It was a great dance for the dance off because it was full of anger. But apparently I was screaming through it because I was just so filled with emotion and fire.
You see, well, you're very competitive. Did you know that about yourself?
No.
You're welcome.
If you had to dance with another dancer / contestant for a week, who would you pick? I know who I'd pick.
Okay,
you go first.
No, I do not. I don't want to pick anyone.
Oh really?
Oh really? You just said.
It's a game. It's a game. It's a game. I don't really want to dance with
them. Yeah, but your brain went there anyway.
Yeah, well, no, but I'm thinking about if there's like someone who I think is really nice, who I'd also get on with. Okay. Not as good as you. If I had to dance with another dancer, it probably would be Kai. Because I really like Kai and he does really good impressions.
Kai
and he's really
nice.
Funny. And he's really good friends with Kat.
Soulmate forever.
That's how it
is. If I had to dance with another one, probably Leighton.
I knew you were gonna say that.
Do you know why? Because when I met him the first time, I think we had this good connection. We started to talk and I could feel like the banter, you know what I mean?
Mm.
But you're always on my first place. You didn't say that, but I said it. Who's the most competitive out of the two of you? I'm passionate.
But this is your job. Your job is a dancer.
You know where it is. It's not a job. I started dancing when I was 6.
Yeah.
And I never stopped. So dancing literally saved my life. Saved it. Like, and the fact that I've got the responsibility to teach you how to dance, there's always the little voice in my head telling me a bit more again. But it's missing 30 seconds. Just one more.
That's why we were late here today. Because you went, just one more run. Just one more. Just one more run.
So it's the fact that you want to be sure that you have done your possible.
Yeah.
So you should appreciate that.
I do appreciate that.
Okay.
Which dance are you least looking forward to and why? I think I feel a lot more comfortable in ballroom. I think the Latin stuff is a little bit more challenging for me. I don't know, I think it just requires a different style. So I think I'm more suited to ballroom, the Latin stuff. The thing is, I've not done loads, so I don't know, but I just know that I prefer ballroom.
I'm glad you said that, because I know that your brain goes in categories, but it's not like that. Just because you placed that, it was your first week, the cha-cha-cha.
Yeah, and then I got three.
So she was thinking, okay, now I'm... it's a journey. You're growing up. The way how you're gonna pick up the steps is quicker. Now let's say your memory of learning the steps is bigger because you've done so many steps.
Yeah,
now.
I guess my memory of learning the cha-cha was the biggest, most challenging few weeks ever because it was literally the first time I'd ever danced in my whole life. So that's
cha-cha-cha.
But cha-cha-cha does have a special place in my heart, I will say.
Yeah.
First dance.
It's the first dance ever. Thank you, Grazia, for having us.
Those were our 10 hot questions.
Ciao!
Bye! Thank you.